You know, there are some people, I've had some of them before, they say, well, I don't know whether I can be saved or not. They say, I hear about salvation. I hear about eternal life. But you know, I don't know whether it is for me or not. Can I tell you, it's a common salvation. It's common to everyone. That means it's available to everyone. That's the use of the word universal. Look at this. I'll read it to you if you don't have a Bible. It's Isaiah chapter 45. Isaiah chapter 45. And I'm reading this. By the time you hear, you're okay. That's what it means. Universal call to the salvation of the Lord. Common, available to everyone. Isaiah chapter 45 verse 22. Look unto me and be saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am God and there is none else. You see that? It says, all the ends of the world, everybody that is as on that end, and you are by that end, and you are by that end, and you are by that end. He says, look unto me. Look unto me. Salvation is for you. It's common. It's universal. It's available to everyone. And then you understand when you get that salvation that is coming from God. Look at this now. God is not stingy with his water. He gives the water to everyone. God is not stingy with the air that we breathe. He gives the air to everyone. God is not stingy with all the provisions he makes. The rain comes from for everybody. And the salvation of God is for you tonight. I said it's for you tonight. That's why it said, look unto me, all the ends of the earth, and be ye saved, because I am God and there is none else. In fact, as I come to Acts of the Apostles chapter 2 verse 21. Acts of the Apostles chapter 2 verse 21. You see what it means when it says it's a universal call. No exception. It's a universal call. No exclusion. It's a universal call. You cannot say, I'm on this side of the fence. I'm on that side of the fence, therefore, maybe salvation is not for me. The word of God is telling you. The Bible is telling you. Bible, that's blessed instruction, bringing life eternal. It tells you that their salvation is yours. Thank God is for me. I say, thank God is for me. I say, thank God is for me. Look at this. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verse 21. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, verse 21. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Whosoever. What does that mean? Whosoever. That means anybody, everybody. All you need to do is call. All you need to do is come. All you need to do is say, I want salvation. I believe Jesus died, and he died for me, and that salvation will come to your heart. Because it says right there that whosoever, put your name there, whosoever, what's your name? Whosoever, I said, what's your name? Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. And that person, as you put your name, as you call upon the Lord tonight, thank God you are saved. I said, thank God you'll be saved. Look at this. Look at John chapter 3. John chapter 3. And here I'm reading from verse 14. Interesting. Very, very instructive. It says in chapter 3 verse 14, it says, and as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up. He was talking to them about what he was going to do. And he wanted everybody to know that this I'm going to do, I'm going to Calvary. I'm going to die on the cross. I'm going to shed my blood, that is to shed my blood, so that there'll be salvation. So that there'll be eternal life. And then he wanted to assure everyone, this is not only for the Jews. You see, there are people that say, this salvation, this Christianity is for the people who are white. Don't ever say that again. It says, as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, even so must the Son of Man be lifted up, Then look at this now in verse 15. That whosoever, that's you there again, that whosoever, who is that? I said, who is that? That whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life. Wonder of all wonders, tonight you can have eternal life. Miracle of all miracles, tonight you can have eternal life, because it says in verse 16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, wonderful, is saying that every time, so that you will not miss it. You'll not say, I don't know whether I'm there or not. You are there. I don't know whether I can get it or not. You will get it in Jesus' name. That whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. I will not perish. I said, I will not perish. You know why? Because it's whosoever believeth in him. And I put my name there. And I said, no, I will not be lost. No, I will not spend eternity with Satan. No, I will not die the death of a sinner, the death of a criminal. I'm going to be saved. He'll forgive my sin. He will change my life. He will give me eternal life, because he said, whosoever believeth, Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. Jesus will be your Savior in Jesus' name. Look at Romans chapter 10. Romans chapter 10. I'm reading to you so that you'll not say, that man said, it's not me. It's not me. This is what the Bible says. Blessed instruction bringing life eternal to you tonight. And this is how that life eternal comes to you tonight. In Romans chapter 10, I'm reading from verse 11. It says, for the scripture says, not me. For the scripture says, that's what scripture there means, holy book, holy writing, coming from behind the heart of God in heaven. It says, for the scripture says, whosoever believeth on him shall not be ashamed. Are you there? I said, are you still there? Whosoever, who is that? Is calling upon you tonight. He's saying, this thing is common to everybody. It's available to everybody. That if you will not be ashamed, ashamed of your sin in eternity, ashamed of your guilt as a sinner, ashamed of your condemnation when you stand before the judgment throne of the Almighty God. It says, if you will not be ashamed on that day, that you are not one of the people saying, okay, I give money to this, I give money to that, I'm a good person. You'll be ashamed of that, because you know, no matter how good you are, and no matter what good works you do, they cannot measure up and match up to the salvation that Christ has made available. But as you say, I know whosoever believes in him will not be ashamed. And then you come, you say, Lord, I believe, I believe, I believe you died for me. I believe you took my sins away. I believe I will be saved even now. That eternal shame will get away from your life in Jesus' name. Look at verse 12. Verse 12. But there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek. That's why it's common. That's why it's common. That is, there's no difference. God is not saying, I favor A and then I don't want B. I favor everyone. I make my salvation available to everyone. It says, for there is no difference between the Jew and the Greek, for the same Lord over all is rich unto all that call upon him. That's the condition there. All that call upon him, you will call on the Lord tonight. I said you'll call on the Lord tonight. And that thing that is called salvation from heaven and from the very heart of God will come in your soul. Will come in your spirit. Tonight is the night of your salvation. Somebody there, I said, tonight is the night of your salvation. Then in verse 13, here we come to that word again. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. It says, don't have any doubt in your mind. As you come and you say, Lord, I'm calling. I'm a sinner. I want your salvation. It says, whosoever, is talking about the man there. Whosoever, is talking about the woman there. Whosoever, is talking about somebody that is, you are hearing the Bible for the first time in your life. It says, it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter. You are coming for the first time today. Whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Come on, salvation. Available for everyone. Available for you. The Lord will save you. It will change your life. You see, I'm reading all these references of the Bible so that you will not think I'm the one that is just mentioning that. You will know. Here is the message of God for you. In 1 Timothy chapter 2. 1 Timothy chapter 2. I'm reading from verse 3. 1 Timothy chapter 2 verse 3. It says, for this is good. Of course, of course. When there's no discrimination, this is good. Of course. When there's no exclusion, this is good. Of course. When there's no exception, when you can come, he can come, she can come, everybody can come and have this salvation, this is good. That's why it says in verse 3, for this is good and acceptable in the sight of God, our Savior. Look at the next verse. Who will have all men to be saved? Who will have all men to be saved? All. Anybody part of all there? Part of all. All. What are you? Wonderful. Salvation is coming your way. That salvation will get you. It's coming from Christ. And when you say, Lord, I believe that Jesus died for me. It says in that verse 4, who will have all men to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. You are coming to the knowledge of the truth. The Lord wants you to have this truth. You will have it. I said you will have it. As you come and you say, Jesus, here I am. I want your salvation. Because you told me it's common. You told me it's available. You told me it's universal. You told me it's for the whosoever. And Lord, I come. He will receive you and give you that salvation. Just one verse for this section. Look at 2 Peter now, chapter 3. 2 Peter, chapter 3. I'm reading from verse 9. In 2 Peter chapter 3 verse 9, the Lord is not slack concerning his promise, as some men count slackness, but is long-suffering towards what? Is long-suffering toward every one of us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. That seals it up for you. You are coming to the Lord tonight. I said you are coming to the Lord tonight. And it says when you come, it says it will give you this salvation because it's a common remedy for a common sickness. It's a common source for all of humanity, all that the Father God in heaven has created. It is provided for all classes of people. And it is given because it is needful and it is available to all men of all races, all men of all generations, all men of every tribe, whatever your tribe, whatever your language, whatever your, whoever you are. The Lord is saying tonight, salvation is offered to each of us and all of us. What salvation? Salvation from sin. Because we're guilty. We have sinned. And then he takes that guilt away because he gives us salvation from guilt. It is salvation from the pollution of sin. You see, when sin comes into our lives, it pollutes us, makes us dirty. And we need some cleansing. And we need a change. And the Lord said, I'll do that for you. I will cleanse you. He will forgive you tonight. He'll remove the pollution of sin from your life. Not only that, there's the penalty of sin. Number one, pollution. The pollution of sin. It takes that away. for everyone, anyone who comes. And then there's a penalty. He takes the penalty, the punishment. He takes that away. And when we talk of punishment, we're talking about real, real punishment with capital P. Because if you sin against the Almighty God, the punishment will be mighty. If you sin against the eternal God, the punishment will be eternal. If you sin against a great God, the punishment will be very great. And then God says, I provided salvation for you. I will take away that great punishment, that mighty punishment, that eternal punishment. He'll take everything away. Salvation from the pollution of sin. Salvation from the penalty of sin. Salvation from the power of sin. You know, sin has power. You say, I will not do that anymore. Sin said, no, I'm more powerful than you are. And that thing comes again and you do it. You need help. And it's a common help available to everyone. Tonight, the Lord will help you. That sin you have been battling with, it will save you from the power of sin. Number one, it saves you from the pollutions of sin. Number two, it saves you from the penalty of sin. Number three, it saves you from the power of sin. Number four, from the presence of sin. You see, in one of the Bible passages, I don't want to read too many to you tonight. It says, I do the things I don't want to do. And the things I want to do, that I cannot do. It says, you know why? Because of the sin that lives inside me, the presence of sin. The Lord will take that presence of sin away. Tonight you're free. I said, tonight you're free. I am free. Where are you? He'll set you free tonight in Jesus' name. And let me come to the second part of what we're looking at. I'm looking at Jude once again. I'm looking at Jude chapter 1, and we're looking at verse 3. Jude chapter 1, verse 3, beloved, it says, when I gave all diligence to write unto you of the common salvation. Now, I'm coming to this salvation now. I'm looking at that salvation from this other angle. Which angle is this? The comprehensive angle. That is, we say that salvation is comprehensive. It has many, many parts. Let me just tell you. Number one, in salvation, there is forgiveness. Forgiveness. And it is the forgiveness. It's not the kind of forgiveness you think about. You see, you have committed 100 sins. You've committed 3,000 sins. And then one by one, okay, you mentioned this, I forgive you. This, I forgive you. Not that one. He bundles everything together. All the sins you ever committed in your life, from A to Z, from small to big, from little to great, from crime to transgression, he bundles everything together and he forgives you. Wonderful. You have forgiveness tonight. I said you have forgiveness tonight. In salvation, we have forgiveness. Number two, in salvation, we have freedom. Because you see, sin is like a cord. When you sin once, there's a rope tied around you. Second time, another rope tied around you. And then as you're sinning and sinning and sinning, you're bound. You're helpless. You're hopeless. And you're not free. Even if you want to jump, you cannot jump. You want to run, you cannot run. You want to do something good, you cannot. Because you are bound by the cord of your sin. And when salvation comes, freedom comes. Somebody there, you're free tonight. All that rope of sin, all that cord of sin that binds you, everything is totally removed. Number three, there is conversion. There is conversion. What's conversion? You see, sometimes you see a piece of paper. The piece of paper is useless. Nobody needs it. You just throw it away. You cannot even use it to write a letter. You cannot use it to write a note. You cannot choose it even privately. When you go to, you know, to ease yourself, the paper is useless. And then we collect the paper, and then we take it to a particular place. There's a machine over there. They call it a converter. And it will then process it, and that useless paper is converted to something useful. Tonight, conversion will come to you. That useless life will become useful. That dirty life will become clean. Because it is part of the salvation we're talking about. Number one, the component parts of salvation. Number one, there's forgiveness for you. He will forgive you tonight. Number two, there is freedom. He will set you free tonight. Number three, conversion. There's going to convert your soul tonight. You'll be a pleasant child from tonight. Happy child of God from tonight. Number four, there's reconciliation. What does that mean? You see, every sinner is saying, I don't want God. I don't like God. He's my enemy. And God is angry with the sinner every day. There is enmity between the sinner and the Almighty God. Because you see, two cannot work together except they be agreed. And because of your sin, you've turned your back against God. Salvation brings settlement. All the enmities cancelled. And there's reconciliation. It says, you are not an enemy anymore. You are my beloved child. Beloved child. Any beloved child there tonight, he will do that in your life. You see, that's what we're talking about. His salvation is forgiveness. His salvation is freedom. His salvation is conversion. His salvation, there's reconciliation. In salvation, there is regeneration. Regeneration is when you generate something new. Something new. You become a new person. Your heart new. Your spirit new. Your attitude new. Everything about you new. There is regeneration. In salvation, there's deliverance. You see, the devil pursues every sinner. Because the devil says, that's my property. That's my slave. And what can you do? A slave of Satan. A slave of evil. That's why what you want, what you don't want to drink, you drink, of course. What you don't want to wear, you still wear. The lies you don't want to tell, you still tell. Because you're under a power that you cannot be free from. But then salvation comes and God tells the devil, take your hand away from that one. It's now my child. It's now my property. Am I talking about somebody there today? Satan will take his hand away from you. All the oppressive spirits will take their hands away from you in Jesus' name. Because there is deliverance in salvation. Number seven, adoption. Adoption. You see, it's like you're an orphan. God says, it's not my child, it's a sinner. Jesus said, it's not my follower, it's a sinner. The Holy Spirit says, I don't know him. He drinks sin like water. He eats sin like food. And then salvation comes. And then God says, now I adopt you into the family of God. There's adoption in the family of God. You just wake up and say, praise the Lord. I even feel different now. I'm a child of God. Adoption. You see what you're talking about? The component parts of salvation. And now there is what we call, if you adopt into the family of God, there's sonship. Sonship. That's why it says, as many as received him, to them he gave power to become the sons of God. Even to them that believe on his name, you have sonship. And then number nine, you have a new life, a new life. I look at you and I say, that's new. I hear your language, I say, that's new. I see your love and your affection, and I say, that's new. I see your relationships, I say, that's new. Because in this salvation, new life comes. If any man be in Christ, is a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things have become new. And then, Number 10, there is redemption. Redemption. It's like you've been in the slave market, and then your price of freedom, jubilee, liberty, redemption has now come, and you're taken out of slavery. That's what you have. Let me read some scriptures to you for you to understand that tonight you're free. I said tonight you're free. Look at John chapter 8. John chapter 8. I'm reading from verse 36. It says, if the Son therefore shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. If the Son of God, looking at you now, wanting to save you now, wanting to turn your life around, it says, if the Son shall make you free, ye shall be free indeed. I see somebody getting free there today. Acts of the Apostles, chapter 5. Acts of the Apostles, I'm reading from chapter 5 and verse 31. Acts chapter 5, verse 31. Look at what it says over here. It says, him, referring to Jesus, as God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. He gives that. You don't pay for that. That's a gift. You come to him and he gives you that forgiveness. He gives you freedom. He gives you forgiveness. And then we're looking at Psalm 51. In Psalm 51, I'm reading from verse 6. See what this king was praying for. And the same thing he prayed for is what you are expected to pray for, because it belongs to the king, it belongs to the subject, it belongs to the citizen, it belongs to the leaders. It's common, available to everyone. Psalm 51, verse 6. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden parts thou shalt make me to know wisdom. Purge me with hyssop, and I shall be clean. Tonight you'll be clean. Wash me, and I shall be whiter than snow. That's only God can do that. Only God can do that. He'll wash your heart. He'll wash your mind. He'll wash your brain. All those things that you remember that will pull you back into the dirt again, he'll wash everything away tonight. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. It says, hide thy face from my sins and blot out how many of mine iniquities? All mine iniquities. Create in me a clean heart, O God. Renew a right spirit within me. He will do it for you tonight. A right spirit within you. Look at verse 12. Restore unto me the joy of thy salvation, and uphold me with thy free spirit. You can see then the component parts. You can see when salvation comes, good things come in your life. I thought somebody there would say amen. Titus chapter 2. Titus chapter 2. Reading from verse 11. It says, for the grace of God that bringeth salvation has appeared unto all men. You see that? That's that again. All men. All men. Universal. It's common and yet comprehensive. And then it says, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly. As that salvation now has come, we're turned around. Conversion has come. A change has come. Transformation has come. We should live soberly, righteously, godly in this present world. In this present world. When are you going to have salvation? In this present world. I said, when are you going to have forgiveness? in this present world. When are you going to have freedom? In this present world, when are you going to have conversion? In this present world, all the component parts of salvation, when are you going to have that total salvation? In this present world, looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God and our Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us, that he might redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people zealous of good works. You see that, number one, the common salvation available to everyone, given to everyone. Whosoever comes to him, he will not cast you away. He will receive you. He'll give you that salvation. Number two, we've seen the composite parts of that salvation. We've seen that forgiveness. We've seen that freedom. We've seen it includes conversion. It includes reconciliation. There is regeneration in it. There is deliverance in that salvation. And there is reconciliation. There is adoption in that salvation. There is sonship. There is a new life. And thank God, there's total redemption. And you know, as you come to Jesus Christ, you believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, if you're sick, he will take that sickness away. Your blind eyes will open. Give me a good luck on your amen. Those who are lame tonight, you'll find the mighty power of the name of Jesus Christ. You rise up and walk in Jesus' name. And that thing the devil packed inside your body, and you're afflicted and you're attacked, when I pray in the name of Jesus and I say, come out, it comes out immediately. Because something miraculous is happening to you today. Miracle explosion coming upon your life today in Jesus' name. Number one, the common salvation everybody will receive. Any candidate of salvation there tonight? You are there, the Lord will bless you. Number two is the composite, is the comprehensive salvation. Number three now, our unrelenting commitment. Untiring commitment. Our commitment until the consummate salvation. See, many people don't understand. They come in at the door and they stay at the door all their lives. Look up here for a moment. As you go to school, you enter the gate and then you stay there at the gate all through the hours of the day. You're at the gate. The people at home said, you've gone to school. The people inside the class, they said, no, you are not here. And then when we close in the day, you take your bag, you go back home. Where are you coming from? I'm coming from school. But you only stayed at the gate. Some people come at the gate like this. What I mean, they come to a crusade. They come to an evening like this, and they hear the word of God, and they take one step and they get to the gate and they stay at the gate there. I'm saved, I'm saved, I'm saved. Come in. And as you come in, you continue, because as you continue, you will conquer every problem in your life. Three things you are thinking about. Number one, calm. But that's just at the gate. Number two, continue. That is what gives you the victory for the rest of your life. Number three, you conquer. Somebody there, I said you conquer. Somebody there say, I will conquer. You come, then you continue, then you will. I want to hear you there. You will conquer in Jesus' name. Look at this now. Consummate salvation. Consummate. Final salvation. consummate salvation, perfect salvation. And that is eternal. Once you enter through the gates of heaven, you are there forever and ever, consummate salvation. We're looking at 1 Peter chapter 1. 1 Peter chapter 1. And I'm reading from verse 3. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy has begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you. There's something there. When you get to heaven, it will be given to you. But what if you don't continue? What if you just stop at the gate? I'm saved. I'm forgiven. I went to the crusade. I gave my life to Christ. Continue. So that inheritance he has for you in heaven, at the consummate salvation, you will have. Look at verse 5. Who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time. Ready to be revealed in the last time. That's why Jesus said, we must continue. Thank God I will continue. I said, I will continue. I said, I will continue. Matthew chapter 24. In Matthew chapter 24, verse 13. But he that shall endure unto the end shall be saved. The same shall be saved. That's talking about consummate salvation, final salvation, eternal salvation. To continue to endure unto the end. My question is, how does that happen? How does that happen? One. Come. Everybody shout, come. What does that mean to come? In Isaiah chapter 1. Isaiah chapter 1. I'm reading from verse 18. Isaiah chapter 1. Verse 18. It says, come now, and let us reason together, says the Lord. Though your sins be as scarlet, they shall be as white as snow. Though they be red like crimson, they shall be as wool. Come. Come out. Come in. Come now. Come out. Out of darkness. Come in. Come into the light. Come out. Come out of your sin. Come in. Come in to the Savior. Come out. Come out of evil. Come in. Come into the grace and the goodness of God. You come out. You come in. You come now. Come now. Today is the day of your salvation. You don't want to stay any longer with Satan in sin and suffering and sorrow. That's why it says, this is the day and this is the time to come. And it says, you come now so that it will forgive you. It will forgive you in Jesus' name. The next word is continue. Continue. Not just that I come and I stay at the gate, but you will continue. Somebody there, where are you? I said, where are you? I will continue. I will continue. I will continue. Look at John chapter 8. John chapter 8. I'm reading here from verse 32. John chapter 8. We're looking at verse 32. In verse 32, look at what it says. And let me back up to verse 31. Then Jesus said to those Jews who believed on him, if ye continue, everybody shout the word continue. If ye continue in my word, then are ye my disciples indeed. You will continue. You don't say, okay, I come to Christ on this beautiful Monday night, and then tomorrow you continue with Satan. I come to the Savior, and then tomorrow you continue with sin. I come to the light, and then tomorrow you continue in darkness. You will continue in Jesus' name. One, you continue in his righteousness. He gives you a gift. He says, I take your filthy garments away from you, and I give you my gift of righteousness. You continue in his redemption. You're free. I'm free indeed. I'm free forever. You will not go to bondage anymore in Jesus' name. You continue in his righteousness. You continue in his redemption. You continue until his revelation from heaven, because he's going to come and he'll be looking for you, because Jesus is coming again. And when he comes again, he'll be looking for the people that came, for the people that continued, for the people that conquered. I see a conqueror over there. I see an overcomer right there. You will conquer every sin. You will conquer Satan. You will conquer every sickness. Tonight is the night of conquering. Am I talking to somebody there? Tonight is the night of victory. And tonight is the night to overcome. Because he calls you to come and conquer. That's why the angel said in Matthew chapter 1 verse 21. And thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. He will save you tonight. I said he will save you tonight. He said, because I overcame, you will overcome as well. Not only that, it's going to make you a conqueror over Satan, over evil spirits, over evil powers. When Christ comes in, Satan has to go out. When light comes in, darkness has to go out. And from tonight, you are a conqueror in Jesus' name. And then you will conquer every sickness. That cancer will not conquer you. That evil power will not conquer you. All that infirmity will not conquer you. I come. I continue. I conquer. Any conqueror there tonight? I said, any conqueror there tonight? Look at Matthew chapter 8. Matthew chapter 8. I'm reading here from verse 16. It says, when the evening was come, they brought unto him many that were possessed with devils, and he cast out the spirits with his word, and healed all that was sick, and healed all that was sick, and healed, tell me, all that was sick, and healed, shout it out, all that was sick. You conquer sickness tonight. That sickness will not go back home with you. Miracle is coming your way. Extraordinary miracle. Extraordinary power. And then it says that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Esaias the prophet. Himself took our infirmities and bare our sicknesses. He'll take everything away. And then in Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8 verse 37. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. Well, you have to speak for yourself. In all these things, I am more than a conqueror through Christ that gave himself for me because he loved me. I come. Say it for yourself. I come. I will continue. I'm a conqueror. Heads bowed and eyes closed. It's now your personal decision for you to say, yes, today the common salvation will be mine. Yes, today that comprehensive salvation will be mine. Yes, today I am pledging myself to continue until the consummate salvation. Forgiveness available, freedom available, conversion available, reconciliation available, adoption available, and becoming a child of God available. He will forgive all your sin. Heads bowed and eyes closed. If you are making up your mind now, Lord, I come, Lord, I come, Lord, I come, you raise up your hand. You say, yes, Lord, this salvation that's available for everyone, I want to have that salvation. I'm part of the whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. Raise up your hand there. You want that salvation in the pavilions over there, everywhere, on the seats over there. You raise up your hand. I want that salvation. Over here on the grounds in front of me, I want that salvation. Where are you? Raise up that hand. If you're raising up your hand, you will stand up. You say, yes, salvation, salvation, salvation is mine today. It's common, it's available, it can be yours today. Stand up right there and say, Lord, I want this salvation. Anywhere you are raising up your hand because you want this salvation available to everyone. Where are you? Where are you? You're raising up your hand. Then you're standing up. Then you're standing up. Anywhere you are. Anywhere you are. And it's coming to you right now. Forgiveness will come. Freedom will come. You'll be adopted to the family of God. You will be a child of God. He'll take away the guilt and the condemnation of sin away from your life. You stand up if you're raising up your hand. I want that salvation. All right? As you're raising up your hand and standing up, you will pray after me. Are you ready? I said, are you ready? You say it aloud and you say it from the depths of your heart. Almighty God, I thank you today. My eyes are opened. My understanding is enlightened. I know salvation is for me. I know Jesus died for me. I know forgiveness is mine today. I know freedom has come to me today. Lord Jesus, shout it. Lord Jesus, forgive my sin. Lord Jesus, set me free from every sin. Lord Jesus, convert my soul. Change my life. I believe. My sins are forgiven. I believe I am free. I believe I've got salvation now. I promise I will continue with Jesus, my Savior, and I will be a conqueror from today. Thank you, Lord. Say it. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name I pray. Raise up those two hands there. That means I surrender to Jesus. Raise up your hand. I'll pray for you now. Father, in the name of Jesus, I thank you for all these who have come to Christ and for all these who came out of sin and they came to the Savior. Out of darkness, they have come to the light. Out of evil, they have come into your grace. Forgive them in Jesus' name. Set them free from every bondage of sin. Cleanse them from the pollution of sin. Cleanse them from the power of sin. Cleanse them from the presence of sin. And take away the penalty, the punishment of their sin. Write their names in the book of life in heaven. Let your spirit bear witness in their hearts. They are now children of God. Thank you, because I know you have answered. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. It has happened. Now we're going to do something very quickly. Our counselors will come to you right there. Keep on standing. Anywhere you are, all around the seats at the stadium, keep on standing. And those of us in front of me, keep on standing. Our counselors are coming. Our calling on our state pastor, Pastor Egunjobi, to come and help us. Just a short time. And then after that, something is coming your way. Miracle explosion. Somebody shout, miracle explosion. After this time now, I'll come back, and then those blind eyes will open tonight. And those people on the wheelchair, you are getting up tonight. All those infirmities, all those sicknesses, they're going tonight. Just a short time, our counselors, please help us very quickly.
Counselors, go inside them very quickly. Make sure you take their correct names. Cancer. Tonight is a special night.
Praise the Lord. I rejoice with Lokoja Kogi State tonight, because your night has come. Night of explosion. Night of signs and wonders. Night of deliverance. Night of miracle. You are going to get healed right now. Are you ready? Counselor, stay there. You will see miracle today. And so if you need healing, you need miracle, any problem in your life, you raise up one hand and you lay the other hand on yourself. And then I will pray. When you hear the final amen, that miracle is there already. And then you will check up. And then you will give a shout of praise to the Lord as you see that miracle. Are you ready? Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for your love. We thank you because there's no exception and there's no exclusion. Your salvation, your deliverance, your healing, your miracle is for everyone. And tonight I come and I pray you will bring all the miracles upon your people in Jesus' name. That spirit of insanity, I command you madness. Come out in Jesus' name. That swelling in your body, any part of your body, that swelling there, I command, vanish away in Jesus' name. And near over there, be removed in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for anyone that is having cancer there, you get healed right now. Lord, manifest your power. Cancer, be healed in Jesus' name. That also I command you, be healed in Jesus' name. Tuberculosis, cough, be healed in Jesus' name. That thing that is tormenting your body, walking from the brain to the body, to every part of the body, that moving object, I command you, come out in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those people that are deaf and dumb. I pray the Lord will touch your ears right now. Touch your vocal cords right now. Open that mouth and speak in Jesus' name. Begin to hear in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray for those who are blind. Touch those blind eyes. Glaucoma, come out in Jesus' name. Cataract, come out in Jesus' name. Those dim blind eyes be opened and begin to see clearly. Lord, perform that miracle of sight now in Jesus' name. Those who have stroke, those who are paralyzed, lame in any way, I send forth the power of God upon your body. Rise up and walk in Jesus' name. Your waist retains strength. Your ankles, your knees become strong. Every part of your body, resurrection power come upon you in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that any part of the body that is missing, do a creative miracle. Creative miracle. Creative miracle. Touch them and do it in Jesus' name. Lord, everywhere now, to the left, to the right, to the front, everyone, without exception, touch everyone. Heal everyone. Destroy the works of the devil. Set your people free. Let those blind eyes see right now. Lame legs walk right now. Deaf and dumb hear right now. And all the sicknesses vanish away right now. Confirm the miracle. Confirm the healing. Confirm the deliverance. Thank you, because I know it is done. I know it is done. In Jesus' name I pray. Praise the Lord, it has happened. Check it up, check it up, check it up. You'll see the miracle right there.
Yes, you have got your own already. Every sickness or disease mentioned by the pastor is a settled issue. Just check yourself now. If you are lame, rise up and you can walk now. Throw away your walking stick, right, stand up from your wheelchair and begin to examine yourself. You bring anybody that is blind, test him now. And tell him, can you see my finger? Can you see this paper? Can you see this handkerchief? It's already happening there. It's already happening there. I am waiting for you on the gallery, everywhere. Check up, check up, check up. It's a day of explosion. It's a day of explosion. Everywhere, just check yourself. Check yourself. It has happened. Do what you cannot do before, begin to do now. You cannot walk before, rise up and begin to walk. If you have been using a walking stick or you are using a bracer, put it away and begin to walk. Put away your crutches, stand up from your wheelchair and begin to see the glory, the mighty power of God. Let me hear a shout of hallelujah there as you are coming out and shaking up. Counselors, go inside and see what the Lord has done. Many miracles are happening. You can somebody running up there. So many miracles are happening now. There is great, great move of God right away. You can see up there is happening. Over there is happening. Over there is happening. Over there is happening. How about here? How about here? How about here? Your miracle is there with you already. Your miracle is here already with you. Oh, come out and rejoice in the presence of the Lord. Come out and give glory to God. Come out and say, thank you, Lord. Your blind eyes is open. Your lame leg is healed. And your deafness is gone. Speak to the deaf. It will hear you now. Talk to the dumb. It will begin to speak now. The tongues are loose. The tongues are loose. All the back pain you brought here, you won't see them again. Your back pain is totally okay now. Everything is all right. Everything is all right. Begin to jubilate and give glory to God because God is in this camp. This one is explosion. Explosion, extraordinary. I'm waiting for you. God has touched your life. You are not going to remain the same again. We are waiting for you. Stand up and begin to see what the Lord has done. Stand up and begin to jubilate and glorify the Lord. Those of you here, shake up, shake up, shake up. The miracle is still going on right now. As we are jubilating now, miracles are going on. All our counselors, all our pastors, don't just stand there. Quickly go in the midst of the people and identify them and begin to bring them very close here because they are going to testify tonight. We are going to hear testimony tonight. Already I can see many people throwing away their walking stick and see the power of God. Counselors, go, please go inside them. All our pastors, please go inside there and check up. Examine them. Invite them. Let them tell you what happened. What happened and what happened. What happened and what happened. What happened and what has happened. Before, they couldn't walk. Now they are walking. Bring them out. Before, they are blind. Now they can see. Bring them out. Before, they have back trouble. Oh, they cannot stand straight. Don't stay behind here. Please go back. Go inside the people. Don't just, I can see all of you standing in front here. Please go to the back. Those of you there, if you have got your miracle, just shout it there. Let the counselors be there with you. Where possible, you can come down from the back and then you can find an exit and come down here and give testimony. Otherwise, counselors who are there, you can see how you can document them. But those of you on the ground floor here, the whole floor is yours. The whole place is yours. Tonight is a night of demonstration of the power of God. The demonstration of the miracle explosion that the Lord has wrought among us here. You can see what the Lord has done. Counselors, we are waiting for you. Identify them. You can see jubilation everywhere. Ah, this is grace. You go, just open your mouth and begin to shout hallelujah to the Lord. And begin to praise God. Bring them here. Counselors, please quickly. Don't just stand and look. Go and interview them and bring them here. Bring them closer here. Let them come near here, and then we will begin to identify them one by one. They begin to testify the greatness of the Lord, the mercy of the Lord, the glory of our God, the mighty power of God has been done. This one is extraordinary. This one is spectacular. Yes, no wonder the man of God called it miracle explosion. Oh yes, it's happening there. Somebody discovered his own miracle there. Somebody has discovered his own miracle there. Mighty God. Hey, you can see the wheelchair. Mighty God. Mighty God. Mighty God. You can see there. You can see there. Oh, this. Let the person come here. Don't go and mob him. Let them come here. Counselors, we are waiting. I've seen only one here. Bring all the others here very quickly. Bring the others here very quickly. God has done it. You believe it is settled. God has done it. You believe it is settled. Just believe God. It has been done. You have got it right away. Just come down here. Come down here. You'll be able to give your testimony. You believe God. You are going to see what you see. You'll be able to say, tell us what God has done tonight. We are waiting for the first testifier. Counselors, quickly identify them. Pastor Erewole, please come and supervise them there and see which one we are going to listen to now. All our pastors, please come. All our group pastors, please come out and check up all these great miracles. Marvelous miracle. Spectacular things. We want to hear the first testimony now. Can we listen to that? Take the microphone. You can tell us your name and where you come from, and then tell us what God has done. Amen. Please help her to put the microphone in her mouth so that she can talk. Yes. Go ahead.
Oruko mi ni Titila Yolorun Yomi.
Titila Yolorun Yomi.
Deni sa mo dupe fun ohun la lati Olorun se fun mi leni lati 2013 ni mo ti wa ninu isoro yi on 7 ni mo ni spinal cord mo pe mo ran eni keji mi lowo ni ti mo fi ni spinal cord.
Spinal cord cleared. She has been having spinal cord a problem since 2013, but today you can see her walking. The spinal cord has been removed, and now she can stand up and begin to walk. Put your hand together for Jesus. Kogi people, put your hand together for Jesus.
Praise
yes,
the Lord.
We are taking another one. Counselor, please bring them. Yes.
I have congratulations. Since 9 years now, there is something working in my stomach. So since I left here, that is starting working in my stomach. Now I am nothing working in my stomach again. So praise the Lord. I thank God.
Something working in the stomach has been removed. You are delivered. You are free. I'm free indeed. In Jesus' name. Put your hand together and glorify the Lord. Another testifier. Your name.
Praise the Lord. I want to appreciate the name of the Lord concerning my life. I want to appreciate the name of the Lord because God has done it for me.
Amen.
I want to thank the name of the Lord because as 5 years ago now I'm sick. I cannot walk again. I thank God that this program, God has done it for me. Praise the Lord!
She couldn't walk again for 5 years. Today, he can walk.
I cannot walk, but now I'm walking.
Amen. What can I say? Hey, you can see her. She's walking now. Put your hand together. Put your hand together. Another testifier. Very quickly. Make sure, bring them here. Identify them and bring them here. It's good to glorify the Lord. It's good to tell it to the whole world what Jesus has done in your life. Yes. Another testifier. Another testimony. Yes. Give me the microphone.
Hallelujah. I thank God Almighty. Jesus has done a miracle in my health today. I've been suffering from spinal cord problem, which I cannot walk.
Spinal cord problem.
But today, this night, with the help of man of God, as Pastor W.F. Kumui.
Amen.
Is able to deliver me.
Amen.
And I can walk now.
You can walk now.
Thank God.
You can walk now. Spinal cord problem totally rolled away. Now he can walk now. You know what mean? What did that mean? That means he couldn't stand up and walk. Now he can walk. All the bones are straightened. All the joints are straightened. And God has gotten the glory. Another testifier. I'm waiting for you. Bring them here. Bring them here. There are so many miracles here tonight. And there are so many. It really is an explosion.
Praise the Lord. Mo dupe lowo Olorun, cancer lo se mi. Won ti ni pe ki gi oyan yen, sugbon emi so pe emi o gi oyan yen. Gba ti mo lo soja, so mo wa ri pe won wa su kakiri. Won wa so pe pe eyan kan ko fe se ajin rere ni ni kini lokoja. Emi so pe mi lowo sugbon mo wo owo oko mi o so oko mi so pe ki ma lo emi so pe ma lo sugbon ngba ti mo wa si bi bayi mo dupa lowo Olorun ara nemi nigba ti won wa su sugbon ngba ti won so pe kan gba wale ibi ton dun eyan so ngba ti mo gba wale ori oyan yen ko wa dun mi mo. Praise the Lord.
Cancer of the breast gone. She came here with a cancer in the breast. She came here under severe pain. She just managed to come here by all means. And today God has delivered her. And all the pain of cancer in the breast are gone. Will you shout hallelujah to Jesus there? Another testifier.
Praise the Lord.
This is great.
I'm a police officer. I was attacked by unknown gunmen at the place of my duty. My name is Daniel Ikojo. And since then, I'm unable to walk. I can't walk on my own. I've been suffering. And today God has healed me through the help of the man of God, Pastor W.F. Kumui. Praise the Lord.
A man is a police officer. He had a gunshot that affected his leg. He could not walk. You can see all the braces they put there. He was using walking stick on the two arms. But now, he doesn't need the walking stick again. Now, he can walk. My brother, your miracle is permanent. All those gadgets will be removed completely because God has set you free. Another testifier. Put your hand together for Jesus. You can see the line is very long. Counselor, please, can you make some selection? Let's listen to striking ones. Let's listen to very strike because there's no way we can listen to everybody. You can see the line. But let's take some very striking ones to develop the faith of everyone.
Now go to Jesus. But Banaganita, you're not going to eat on. Thank you, Jesus. Good. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, sir. Now go to Jesus. Dabanagani. I'm going to eat agony. Come in agony. Now go to.
I need a Usa interpreter.
He's thanking God for God has opened his eyes. Before he cannot see, but now he can see. And he's giving praises to God.
He was blind, but now he can see. Let's test him.
Now, what is this?
speak out to him.
Takardani.
He said it's a paper.
Amen. It is established. The healing is established. Complete. Blind eyes open. He can see now. Go and give the glory to God and continue with the Lord Jesus Christ. Another testifier. Just tell us your name and tell us quickly what God has done.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank God for my
Let the mother tell us.
Praise the Lord. Our Lord is good. This boy, since 7 years now, he not the year in time.
He not the year.
But today, as I carry and come here, when a man of God, they pray, I lay my hand for the 2 years.
Uh-huh.
But now he can hear very well. I thank God for delivering.
Let's test him.
Go.
Jesus, say Jesus.
Jesus,
put your hand together. The dumb, the deaf is hearing now. He was deaf before, now he can hear clearly. Another testimony. God is not discriminating at all. As he's healing the adult, so he's healing the children. Here is another one.
Praise the Lord!
Hallelujah!
My name is Yakub Oluwaseun from Ajakuta District. Here is my cousin sister. She can't speak, she can't hear. But after the prayer of the man of God and the prayer of some workers in the church, God really performed his wonder through the man of God. Praise the Lord!
Let's test him. You say he can speak here now.
One. Two.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. You know, he has not spoken before. He can respond. That means he's hearing and he can also respond. Put your hand together for Jesus. Na so so wonder Jesus they do. Na so so wonder Jesus they do. Hey, he has done it for me. Hey, he has done it for me. Oh, he has done it for you. Na so so wonder Jesus. Praise the Lord! This is an explosion indeed. Explosion by excellence.
Praise God. My name is Mrs. Wilfred Obagboye. I've been down with stroke for the past 6 years. But after the man of God prayed, I cannot walk without support. I have been using support before. I cannot walk without support. Praise God.
6 years stroke. Vanish like that. 6 years stroke. Vanish like that. You can see her. She's now walking on her own. She couldn't walk without a support before. But now the stroke has bowed at the mention of the name of Jesus from the mouth of his anointed servant. Shout hallelujah. Another testimony. Hey, another testimony. Yo, why? Let her talk in outside word, then you interpret. Yes.
So, Yunana Enusa was a man. Am I under the sauki? Not the sauki.
Okay, his name is Inusa. He was having a problem of the spinal cord.
Amen.
And his eyes cannot see very well. But after the prayer of the man of God, now he is free from the back and now he can see very well.
Double miracle. The spinal cord removed and the blind eyes also removed. Put your hand together for Jesus.
Mungo da Allah, Tiwa da Allah, Sauka mana yanzu, Allah ya kawo mana sauki. ciwon kunne da nake da shi yanzu wannan guda daya yanzu Allah ya sa da sauki kafafuna ma yanzu alhamdulillah ina jin sauki.
He was having problem with his legs and his eyes, but all of them the Lord has taken care of them and now he is well, and both of them are Muslims.
Amen. God is loving, God is wonderful, God is marvelous. She was blind, now you can see. Yes.
Alhamdulillah ciwon alhaji ma'azu ciwon da muke da shi kuma Allah ya kawo mana sauki mun samu lafiya. Eh azine muka samu ni fadi ina jin ciwo ko tafiya nake yi bana iya wata tafiya sosai ta gwaiwa kuma madam Allah ya mata albarka da ka kawo mu nan wanda ka ji dadi wallahi muna yi mata godiya sosai madam. To sunan nata ne ban san sunan ta ba amma muna yi mata godiya ita ta je ta kawo mu nan kuma mun gode.
He is appreciating God because he once had an accident, he cannot walk very well. A sister invited both of them and all of them have received their miracles to the glory of God.
Amen. Jesus is wonderful. Jesus is marvelous. Jesus is good. Oh, everybody say Jesus is good. Oh, Jesus.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
I'm happy for this night. It's happy. 2 years now. My mom can't see. She can't walk up. But this night, she feel do anything now. Praise the Lord!
You can see her mother.
She's, thank you, Jesus.
She's wondering, what am I seeing?
See me before, but them say he see me this night.
He can see people now. He can see now. Put your hand together for Jesus. God is good. He has done me well. Oh, my soul, rise up and praise the Lord. You cannot sing again. Amen. Our God is good.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. My name is Sister Yusuf Elizabeth Adetutu from Ampa region in this Kogi state. I bless the name of God. I worship the name of God for God answering my prayer. After 24 years of childlessness, last year, February 12, 2015, the Lord blessed me with a miraculous pregnancy. Grant me successful pregnancy. And I put to bed successfully without operation, without any problem. Here am I with my baby, Ruth. And I say, evidence. Oh, he know his name. Whoever you are, and you are looking unto God for the blessing of the womb, my God can do it. Stay calm. Have patience. Have faith. God of miracle will visit you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah. You are no longer barren. You are going to be fruitful. Those of you are here. By this time next year, by the time the man of God comes again, you'll be bringing your baby to show.
Praise the Lord. Praise the living God. By the grace of God, I'm from Muslim home. But the Lord deliver me and bring me out of danger into his marvelous life. I married 2010, October. By the grace of God, I was passing through a lot of sin because we are in Lagos, in Korodu location. I was passing through a lot of things, a lot of mockery, even in the neighborhood. But I bless the name of the Lord to the greatest extent that God surprised me in January 2012. And I gave birth successfully the baby at my back on September 17. I bless the name of the Lord. Last year again, the Lord Almighty blessed me. I was with that baby, heart attack came. I was fainting. This daddy Kumui visited our is Ikorodu location, my daddy can bear me witness. I was there fainting. In fact, my pastor
summarize.
May help him and strengthen his ministry in Jesus' name. Here am I in Kogi State. I'm whole and active. Whoever you are, the Lord Almighty will deliver you. You will never remain the same in Jesus' name.
Amen. Please, let's be selective. Let's hear testimony of what happened tonight here. We want to hear what happened today, because we want to establish the explosion that God has already performed. Yes. Next testifier.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. I thank God. I've been having an accident over 2 years ago on 4th June, year 2014. I have done operation 2 times without successful, but God have sent man of God to me today. I receive a healing. I walk down from up there to this place without crutches.
You can see his crutches raised up.
God
has healed him. He can now walk without the crutches again. Give all the glory to God. Can I hear another amen? Another testifier.
Praise the Lord. This woman standing here, her name is Alieri Haruna. She's from Koto Karife. I was the one that invited her to this program. When she came, she said she was sick since last year, 1 year and 3 months. Every month they take her to the hospital, admit her with drip and other things. And now, as I invited her to this program, she came to the program tonight. As the man of God prayed, something has been working inside her stomach. Immediately after the prayer, she said something moved out of the stomach. And she shouted, she said she will come and testify. Praise the Lord. May the name of the Lord be glorified in Jesus' name.
Amen. That woman was delivered and set free, and our counselor brought her here to tell us how God set that woman free. Tonight, God will set you free. I say God will set you free. You are not going home with your problem. You are not going home with your problem. If you have not really established your something, don't come and testify. Let God perfect what he has done. Yes, next testifier.
Everybody, hello, logo. Oruko mi ni Rebecca Adeyeye lati Yagba region. Mo dupe lowo Olorun fun akoko igbala okan mi. Mo dupe lowo Olorun lati igba ti mo ti wa ni kekere ti mo ti gbaju mara mi. Eti ata mo tu gba ti o tun di bi oku ose kan ti an bo nbi eti wa serious gan.
She had been having problem in her ear, and the thing was increasing, the pain was increasing, even when she come here today. But now God had healed her completely. The pain, the ear problem is gone. Give all the glory to God again. Can we shout another amen? Give the microphone to her. Let her say what she wants to say. Stand up and talk. Fear not. Stand up. God has taught you. Yes. Maybe let's give her time to settle herself. Another testifier. Counselors, please select those things that happen here today. Hallelujah.
I'm Sister Elizabeth Omale from Olamaboro region. Since I came here this morning, I'll be praying that God should visit me and my family. So when GS was praying this evening, all the prayer he prayed was on my family. Praise the Lord. And my second testimony is that I'll be feeling
Where are you running to? We have not finished. The man of God is here. Where are you running to?
I'll be finished spending
the patient
years ago, and I'll be spending money on it. But tonight, after the prayer of the man of God, I hear a sign in my chest, shalom, and everything was over. Praise the Lord!
Put your hand together for Jesus Christ. Can I hear another amen?